Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching Geekcaster. My name is Phil Geeks, and we've got Davion, and we've got Corey. And you're watching Geekcaster, everything sci-fi, fantasy, geek content, technology, food, and other social convos. Wow, that was a lot. But that's what's going on over here. That's what's going on. So today, we're going to talk about WandaVision. We're going to talk about Judas and Messiah. What was that called?
Judas and the Black Messiah.
Black Messiah.
Yeah. All right. And then we're also going to talk, our main topic is going to be technology and how it affects different aspects of our lives, changing things. And what's our prediction for, I guess, by the end of 2021? All right. So let's go into the content really quick. So Judas and the Messiah?
Black.
That's such a big title. It's such a big title. I just the title has controversy. What is that about?
So it's an allegory for what actually happened for the actions that transcended up to Fred Hampton and the Black Panther Party.
Okay. So somebody betrayed somebody, and then boom. Right. Well, how was it? How was the acting? Was it close to history? Because I know you guys are really good with that. So how well did they do with the with that film?
It was really phenomenal. Like, to me, I really loved it. It was really, like, it was something to watch and get clarity of what happened behind the scenes, what led to the Fred Hammond and the Black Panthers, if I said the name correctly.
Fred Hampton.
Hampton and the Black Panthers, you know, and it gives you an idea and it gives you a view from a different perspective of the person that caused the whole, downfall pretty much.
Now, where can people watch this? Is that a Netflix thing or a Prime thing or?
HBO Max.
HBO Max.
Oh.
HBO Max.
HBO but is really,
it is theater.
Oh, you can see it in the theaters too.
Yes.
That's amazing. It's kind of cool you have the option. I don't know. If I had to pick between the theaters and home, which one, I guess it really goes to what Corey said one of our past shows. He was like, hey, you know, if it's a blockbuster, we need to see this in a theater. You know, if it's something huge, something action-packed, like what's the point of watching at home? But this one sounds like definitely home and make your own popcorn.
Yes. Or your own nachos.
Or your own nachos. Or tacos. Anybody there like tacos?
So, Tuesday. Today's Tuesday. Oh.
Taco Tuesday! Taco. Sorry.
No problem. So, yeah. All right, so the new installment of WandaVision, I'm feeling it. I see what's happening here. The end kind of disturbed me, though. But I did like the episode overall. What are you guys thinking?
That's what it's supposed to do. It's supposed to disturb you. It did what it was supposed to do.
The current debate right now is who's the Well, there's two. Who's the mastermind? Is it Mephisto or is it Nightmare? And the other question that people are asking is, who is her friend? People are thinking it's Reed Richards. Personally, I think it's Nick Fury. But there could be a lot of other candidates as this mystery friend that she has to meet. So Davion is like dying to like spoil it. Are you going to spoil it? Don't spoil it.
Now you're saying spoil it just because of the comics, right?
I said, don't spoil it.
I'm not spoiling it. I'm just making a prediction.
What's your prediction?
It's a prediction. Darn it. And when I say predictions, sometimes it comes true.
And most of the time, it doesn't.
Anyway, it is not Reed Richards. I really think it's a certain person that wears blue. That's all I have to say.
Same person that wears blue.
I mean, it's a prediction. You could tell us. You don't have a secret prediction.
Are you thinking Blue Marvel? Blue Marvel.
Blue Marvel.
Interesting.
And then also, it's a lot of Easter eggs in this episode. It's a lot. Hey, didn't I prove my point? I proved my point. Yes, I was right on my prediction. He is not Mephisto. I mean, he's not Pedro. He's not Pedro.
What do you mean?
He's not Pedro.
How so?
He's not Quicksilver.
How so?
Dude, pay attention to everything he says.
Mm-hmm.
That's not Quicksilver-like and not Pedro-like.
What do you
not
mean?
Not even the Fox version of Pedro. It's not.
It is.
It is not.
I thought so. With the witty and like the mannerisms, it definitely seems like the Fox version of Quicksilver.
No. Then he sneaks up behind her and tries to scare her. Come on. He's like, come on. That's not Quicksilver. It's not Pedro.
It's a 90s show, so you're forgetting that element because a lot of stuff like that happened. It was very Malcolm in the Middle-esque, so you did have a lot of shows that did the zany, I don't want to know what you want to call it, but these antics. And that just reminded me of a 90s era show, which is what we've had previously. So to continue with the themes of bringing in things from certain decades, that just seemed like a 90s thing to do. Like, because it's been in every show that you could think of. Malcolm in the Middle, Clarissa Explains It All, Buffy the Vampire, like all those 90s shows, they had that little stupid scare.
Now, the only thing I could say, like, let's say, all right, Davion, because I did find it was a little weird. I wondered if he was, there was one line that he said, like, well, who really did this? Remember? Mm-hmm. Remember when he was like, well, I know you did something. Was it you? How'd you do it? And, like, why would he act, you know? So I was a little confused about that.
Exactly.
But the thing, and I thought what you thought, but the only problem is when she had that flashback of him being dead,
mm-hmm.
that part said, all right, no, he has to be real. Because, remember, he did the same thing with Vision. So
yep.
Then it was like, all right, that theory's out of the park there. I don't know.
I'll tell you, that theory stays up there because it could be just an image, but not actually who they really are. Or she probably think it through her whole transition of making this world the way she wanted, of what is actually in the back of her mind of what is occurring.
But think about it. So how does she apply past visions to something that really happened? And now she's making a completely new image with something that possibly happened to a person that doesn't exist. That line of thinking to me just doesn't add up. But if you actually like pay attention, they all know that they're in this dream state. He was brought in, so why can't he have like this shared dream state? They know that this isn't real. They know that it's of her creation. So everyone's asking her these questions. Do you want something changed? Is this what you want? Do you want me to go back and do this take all over again? Hey, Wanda, I'm your brother. Tell me, what really happened? What's going on? Why are we doing this? So I think all those lines of questioning all add up because they know something's just not right here.
That's weird. And like I don't know. It's almost like this theory. Remember the last time I said, if she didn't create this world, did she ask someone to create it for her? Or she was suffering so much, someone says, you know what, I'm going to create this world for you and take away your suffering. That's my theory. If there's someone else involved, she was a part of it, even though she didn't have the power to do it. Did that make sense?
Right. No, it makes perfect sense. Because she even said, like, she can't bring people back from the dead, but Vision's back from the dead, so that obviously means someone else is working with her. I think there's an Infinity Stone that's involved, but there's definitely another master player involved as well.
And also, just to let the audience know, in the next 3 episodes, it's going to be an hour.
Right. And you could see it on Disney. Okay. So let's move on, because some people they want to talk about something else. So what do we got so far? We talked about WandaVision. What was the first one you spoke about?
Messiah in the Black.
Oh, here's one. Especially before you love bunnies, you know, are you guys getting all romantic underneath the quarantine love banner? Malcolm and Marie. Malcolm and Marie was interesting. I love it. I love the style, the cinematography. I thought that was pretty cool. A lot of yelling in the script. I don't think I could ever watch it again, but I'm glad I saw it.
I kind of think it's the perfect Valentine's Day movie.
For dysfunctional relationships. Or relationships that, hey, I'm glad we don't got all that going on.
Right. And that way, when you're talking to that person, like, do you get this? Can we talk about future things like this? Are we on the same wavelength? Are we having these same you don't agree with it, but are we on the same level as like mental state? And you can find like a lot of information just by watching this one movie.
I think so. And or listen, if you ain't got nobody, you watch this movie, you're like, I don't need nobody bring me down like that over there. It's too much. Yep, I said it. So are you giving thumbs down? Are you giving thumbs down for a specific reason? Why giving thumbs down,
man? I don't know what you're talking about. I'm just sitting here being quiet.
We all saw you.
I think all the audience saw you too.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Kids don't, you know, the kids that watch this program don't like you not telling the truth, baby.
To all the little kids out there, I didn't do it.
They're like, yes, you did. We saw you.
You saw nothing. And I rest my case. I plead the fifth. Next topic.
Okay. All right. But yeah. Yeah, I thought it was pretty good. Zendaya. I'm liking her. She's a little sassy thing.
She's no longer Disney.
She's no longer what?
A Disney star. She's in her own woman. She's grown up, and it was interesting.
Yeah, her show Euphoria. She's saying, listen, I could do more than Daria type characters. I can do crazy and emotional. I wanna see you do comedy. That's what I wanna do. In fact, Zendaya, I think you should do comedy with me called Zendaya and Phil. Yeah.
She's got her hands full with Spider-Man. She's busy on Spider-Man. I think she's hilarious in Spider-Man. She does a good job.
Le'Veon, you all right there? Yeah. Oh, we're talking about his woman. I don't think we can talk about her anymore.
No, she's never my woman. I told you who my woman was.
Who's your woman?
Who? Rihanna?
She's number 2.
Who's your woman?
Rosario Dawson. But anyway.
you take that back. You take that back, sir.
Fight.
I honestly did not see that coming. Well,
okay. All right. So now let's go to our main topic, technology. I mean, we see where things are going these days. And by the way, you're watching Geekcaster. That's right. Yeah, so we see where things are going this day. And Corey, you said something really interesting before the show. You said that, because we were talking about like OnlyFans, and I was saying like, you know, my feelings and stuff towards that, and you were saying, listen, the future is people don't need to have a job. They just need to figure out a way to get credits. Some sort of thing, like in the movies and something like that. But, do you think there'll be like a ricochet effect where because there are very few jobs, because so many things will be taken over by robots, that the only thing that you could really judge people is not even their job, just how they get their credits? And will that create a whole nother social structure? Like, oh, you get your credits that way. Oh, you get your credits that way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, it's the same thing. How do you earn your income? Oh, that's what you do? All right. And it's just going to evolve. It's going to be the same thing, but it's the natural order of economics.
Well, I have a loophole that I didn't want to mention before, but I'm going to mention it right now. All right, ladies and gentlemen, rock with me on this one. In China, there's this whole thing with kind of like social media. There was an episode of Black Mirror where you got points, or kind of like credits or points or whatever like that, and it was based on likes and dislikes. And your whole life was dependent on these things. So you, and now in China, they have a thing where you have to be socially responsible and within the structure of what the government feels you should be doing. You have to be, so in other words, like if you have pictures on your Instagram that the powers that be feel that are not appropriate, you lose points. You get thumbs down. If you, whatever website you go to, things that you post. Now, the interesting thing about this is that based on those numbers will be like, can you get into the right schools? Can you get a loan? Can you get a mortgage? It's all based on these numbers. So depending on who's in power, and if this goes into effect, you just can't get money any and anyhow. Like, it really is going to determine if you are within good standing and reputable. Now, I don't know what that means, but that means that could interrupt your skin, you know, your skin color, your religion, who you love, how you love. And yes, if you go like this on a website and have creepy men give you money, that could affect that too. So what do y'all think about that?
It's been done in movies, pop culture, anime. Do I think it's sustainable? It's certainly one reality. I don't think that it'll come to fruition. People will rebel every time. So even if that system were to be implemented, the only logical solution is to take yourself out of the system. So there will be another subculture outside of that system where people will be able to make their own credits and do their own thing. It's just the natural order of humans. So I don't think that it's real or it's going to evolve to that point. However, if it does, then there will always be people who disagree with it, and they will probably go off the grid, so to say. So will it create this whole other subculture in humanity that goes against the rating system? Absolutely. And we've seen that time and time again through various medias and pop culture.
Yeah.
Don't just say, yeah, I want to know what you think there, Davion.
Like, I totally agree with Corey on that part, because let's say if we do decide to do it, besides money, we do likes. How many people are going to start rebelling? Because it's not going to be, you can manipulate likes. You can manipulate anything you want to because of the fact that this is an easily manipulated society. I can manipulate you into liking me. But does it have these repercussions? Yes. It could backfire. And will the people rebel on it? Yeah. Like, look at right now what's going on with politics and everything else going on with the Black Lives Matter. People are rebelling against, besides being quiet, because people actually show video of what was going on, people are rebelling. So I'm combining this into what we're saying because of the fact that no matter what we do, it's always going to be some type of rebel at the end.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think the power is in the people. So if the people will agree that this system does not work for the people, then that's how you get rebellions and that's how you get uprisings. So if society actually says, you know what, this is a good thing for everyone and this is equal, there's going to be a lot of changes in our values and how we interact with each other as human beings. Now we're just going to be in a system and a lot of people aren't going to stand for that. Like, we're no longer people. Now we're working towards a social media account. So we're living accounts and people are going to rebel against that. I don't see that being sustainable.
Yeah, because bad enough, if you really look at it, if we all was equal pay, equal everything, somewhere down the line, somebody going to rebel against it. Because whether the person works more than the person that is equal or less than, that's what's going to happen. Somebody's going to rebel. Look at the way the jobs are when we work into our field or work in some type of field. You always got the lazy person and the hardworking person. The lazy person gets paid more, while the hardworking person is getting paid less and less and always get extra work.
Did we answer your question, Phil?
No, but I'm interested in I'm thinking about what I'm thinking. I don't know if I'm
but
thinking.
Corey, you understood what I was saying.
Mm-hmm. I've seen it, and it's funny because there was an anime called Psycho Pass where everyone had this rating, and the rating was whether you're a contributing member of society or if you're going to be one of those people who rebel against society, you're going to be more susceptible to causing crime, and they locked you away for things you have not even done yet. So if you have a system where people who have to work for likes, not everyone is that sociable, not everyone is aesthetically pleasing to the masses. So what happens to those people who can't just get likes for the life of them? What happens to them? And all I can see is all roads leading to an uprising. I just don't see it as a realistic way to govern society.
Yeah, and or if anything, just all roads and the chaos. Because wow, between what both of you are saying, like you're gonna have a big difference between quote unquote who's productive. And then who's visually pleasing, which, you know, the whole concept of, like, beauty culture and beauty privilege, where, like, you know, well, what's the point of you? Like, if robots do all the grunt work and, you know, you have labs making things and it's like, well, but what's the point of you? Why, you know, why are you here? I'm like, oh, well, I'm pretty.
And that's the whole point.
You know?
Yeah, because that's the whole point. We going off? We're leaving? Or
yeah. Wow. I mean, because a lot of people looking at, like, virtual money as, like, yeah, we're getting away from the government and we're doing all this and it's great. But I've never thought about all the dark side. Like, if we get away from that, I mean, you're still creating, because even the people that want to be the disruptors, and I get it, but then they're being disruptors, with the mentality of capitalism. So you're still gonna end up with the super rich and the super poor. Like, right. You know what I mean? And
no matter how you...
Yeah, so really, this is not helping anyone but those that are like investing in being the next titans. Like, we wanna be the all barons of the future. That's the only difference.
Yeah, because everybody's trying to get up to that mountain and grab that brass ring. Like Vince McMahon would say, you have to climb Mount Rushmore and grab that brass ring. And you'd be like, the heck? So I have to take out all my friends and everybody and kick them to the curb just to grab the brass ring? Some people, they'll do it. They'll be like, yeah, if my mom was halfway near me, I'd kick my mom off the mountain. But that's how people think.
Wow.
Because that's how money, if you give it, I mean, that's how some people think about how money is. Money is life. Really, money is time, not life. Your energy, your time that's spent, that you do, everything is, time is money and money is time. That's the best way to put it.
So, I mean, do you guys agree that whether it's paper money, whether it's gold or silver, or whether it's cryptocurrency, it still leads dark. For the first time, I'm thinking it still leads down a dark tunnel.
Yes, I agree. Yeah, everything has its darkness. Everything has its darkness. No matter how you look at it.
Specifically, this. Yeah, I'm just saying, this is dark.
Like money,
for the first time.
Yeah.
I'm confused. I'm upset here.
There's nothing to be upset about. That's just how the world works. Like, money makes the world go around. And while the world is going around, there's always some darkness involved. Like, when money is made, there's always darkness rolling right behind that money.
All right, well, before we get out of here, any words of wisdom, Corey, before we go?
Yes, I forgot to mention about Judas and the Black Messiah that we based off of a documentary, Eyes on the Prize. So if you've ever watched the documentary and you watch this movie, it gives you a better insight into the actual life of being a Black Panther, the party. It's a very good watch. I think everyone should watch it. It's a very good piece of conversation as far as money. Invest, do your research, and just live the best life you can and make sure you love one another.
Yeah, and I say learn how to make donuts because, when we have this official apocalypse, everyone wanna trade stuff for donuts.
Resources. If you mine resources, you will always be at the top because you always see one mogul who mines all the resources and they sell it at an exorbitant amount. You'll still have capitalism. That guy's probably going to die after there's an uprising. Always happens. And then, just make sure you have an abundance of
donuts. Think about it. Fear the Walking Dead.
Don't think about it.
Fear of the Walking Dead. Whoever had donuts would be like, whoa. And no one will kill the donut maker. Think about it. I wouldn't do it.
No one will kill the doctor either, because you're still going to need a doctor. So
yeah. So doctors, people that make donuts.
No. I think they'd kill the donut man.
No. Carol baked cookies. And Carol cannot die because she baked cookies.
Facts.
No, you mean a chef. You mean chef, not a donut maker, a chef.
All right. Tell everybody your social media there, guys.
Davion Busty on Instagram and Facebook, and the Shamar Williams Show on Instagram and Twitter.
You can find me, Corey Davis, at IMGT3 on all of the things.
Geekcaster, geekcaster.com. Geekcaster on IG, Geekcaster Network on the Facebook.
Oh, he finally got a key.
Finally
going
got
a what? A Geekcaster on Instagram and Facebook. Congratulations. You're going, please.
Okay.